How are you doing today? How is your soul today? Can you describe in such a way that we can feel the presence of God? How are you doing? Good. Blessed. And Ali, can you introduce... I forgot the name. Welcome. I forgot the name. Sorry. Jean. Welcome, Jean. Welcome and welcome, everybody. Good morning. Today, as we worship the Lord, I know that God will do something for us. Amen. And let us forget those baggages before us and baggages that makes us struggles, pain and upset, angry, whatever negativity. Church, today we gather because God will open our hearts, open our minds, open the doors, and let us open the grace of God, that God will speak His word to us today. Amen? So some of announcement is, let us keep on praying for our 10th year anniversary. We are on the countdown, December 1st. And we have a lot of activities from September, October, November, until December. But before that, we have also our regular activities, such as tomorrow, 6 o'clock, you are all invited. Let us continue our Monday Bible study, the walk. We are on the session 4, right? Session 4, the walk book, 5 essential practices in a Christian faith. So you are all invited to join us 6 o'clock at the social hall. And then Tuesdays, every Tuesday is 9 o'clock. You know what? Prayer is power, right? And prayer is our passport in our connection to the Lord. So you are all invited every Tuesdays, 9 o'clock. And we have a lot of activities and ministries. I may say ministry, okay? It's not only an activity, but ministry in serving people, community, and serving God. Please check out our newsletter. You can find all a lot of stuff out there, ministries and our doings. So let us pray for that. And I am also, please pray for our seminar at Phoenix, Arizona on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. All the ethnic church planters sponsored by NUF and Vital Ministry of the Church. So it's a free seminar for all the new church planters. We will be leaving Tuesday morning, so we'll be back Thursday. So please pray for our going and the seminar and the lecturers too. So church, where are the children? The children are here. Children and youth, yeah, we will pray for you. Please, 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 come. Come, come, come. Okay, Barbara will lead us in children's moment. Thank you, Barbara.
Oh, she's getting a ride. She's so lucky.
The daughter and dad.
All right. Is there a difference between smart and wise?
Smart and wise.
Okay, what is the difference between being smart or being wise? You don't know? All right. The dictionary says that being smart means you know a lot of facts. You know the answers to some questions. Being wise means that you make wise decisions or good decisions, healthy decisions. So that's the difference between being smart and being wise. So now I'm going to give you a little quiz. Maybe if my phone works. Okay. Now, let's see. All right, I'm going to ask you some questions. You're going to tell me if you think they're wise or smart. Okay? oh, my goodness. My phone is being uncooperative here. Okay, let's see. Eating a balanced meal every day, is that smart or wise? Smart. Okay. Adding up the cost of all the groceries while you are shopping in the store. Smart or wise?
I don't think wise.
Smart. Okay. Locking the front door before bedtime. Smart or wise?
Wise.
Oops. Okay. All right. Giving money to the church each Sunday, smart or wise?
Wise.
Okay. Saving some of your birthday money instead of spending it all on candy, smart or wise?
Smart.
Okay. Getting all A's on your report card at school, smart or wise?
Smart.
Okay. Who knows what's right for us?
God,
yeah. Somebody out there is pretty smart. That's right. God knows. And how does God tell us what's the right thing to do?
Praying.
Praying might be give us an answer. How about reading the Bible?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. How about listening to the pastor? Yeah? Yeah.
And teachers.
And the Sunday school teachers. And the nursery school teachers. All right. Let's see. Okay. Who is the smartest person you know?
Grandpa.
Grandpa. I like that answer. Well, in my case, it's my sister. She's just always so smart. All right. And who is the wisest person you know?
God.
Okay. Good. And maybe
Jesus.
Jesus. Good answer. I like it. All right. Good job. Okay, I have a little tiny prayer, and then we'll let the pastor do his thing with us. The attitude of prayer. God of wisdom, help me to follow your wise path in making good choices. God of wisdom, help me to find happiness that lasts forever. Amen.
Amen.
All right, pastor, we're ready.
They will be singing, right?
Yeah.
Oh.
They will sing Jesus Loves Me.
Okay. All righty.
Right? You know it.
Okay, stand up.
Okay, stand up. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me this I know. Ready?
Will you please stand for the call to worship? The heavens shout of God's glory. There's so much beauty in this earth and in the heavens. Day by day, we are reminded of God's creative love. Come, let us praise the God of creation. Let us sing and shout our praises of thanksgiving and joy to God. Amen. Pray together. God of wisdom and truth, speak to us now. Inspire us with your word. Speak clearly to our hearts that we may walk in your ways and live in your love. In the name of Christ, our Messiah, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Good morning.
Our first scripture reading this morning is Proverbs 1, 20 to 33. Wisdom speaks. Wisdom shouts in the streets, wherever the crowds gather. She shouts in the marketplaces and near the city gates. She says to the people, "How much longer will you enjoy being stupid fools? Won't you ever stop sneering and laughing at knowledge? Listen as I correct you and tell you what I think. You completely ignored me and refused to listen. You rejected my advice and paid no attention to what I warned you. So when you are struck by some terrible disaster, or when trouble and distress surround you like a whirlwind, I will laugh and make fun. You ask for my help, but I won't listen. You will search, but you won't find me. No, you would not learn. And you refuse to respect the Lord. You rejected my advice and paid no attention when I warned you. Now you eat the fruit of what you have done until you have stuffed full with your own schemes. Sin and self-satisfaction bring destruction and death to the stupid fools. But if you listen to me, you will be safe and secure without fear of disaster." For the second reading in the morning, stand if you're able. A reading is from Mark 8, 27 to 38. Who is Jesus? Jesus and his disciples went to the villages near the town of Caesarea Philippi. As they were walking along, he asked them, "What do people say about me?" The disciples answered, "Some say you are John the Baptist, or maybe Elijah. Others say you are one of the prophets." Then Jesus asked, "Who do you say I am?" "You are the Messiah," Peter replied. Jesus warned the disciples not to tell anyone about him. Jesus speaks about his suffering and death. Jesus began telling the disciples what would happen to him. He said the nation's leaders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law of Moses will make the Son of Man suffer terribly. He will be rejected and killed, but 3 days later, he will rise to life. Then Jesus explained clearly what he meant. Peter took Jesus aside and told him to stop talking like that. But when Jesus turned and saw the disciples, he corrected Peter. He said to him, "Satan, get away from me. You are thinking like everyone else and not like God." Jesus then told the crowd and the disciples to come closer. And he said, "And if you want to be my followers, you must forget about yourself. You must take up your cross and follow me. If you want to save your life, you will destroy it. But if you give up your life for me and for the good news, you will save it. What will you gain if you own the whole world but destroy yourself? What could you give to get back your soul? Don't be ashamed of me and my message among these unfaithful and sinful people. If you are, the Son of Man will be ashamed of you when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy angels." The word of God for the people of God. The gospel of our Lord.
Prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
Please be seated. It's been a long time that I haven't sing a song, right? So I will sing How Great Thou Art today. And if you can join me, join me.
Consider all the works thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I pray that God his Son that's sent him to die, my scarce can take it in, that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my soul, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou
God be the glory. If you wanted to sing, just let me know and let Sarah know. Next Sunday, you can sing. Or the following Sunday. Or the third Sunday, wherever you're free. Just let us know. Amen? Okay, so church, join me in attitude of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you today, this beautiful Sunday morning, with grateful hearts. We're here to seek your wisdom and guidance. Lord, as we reflect on the words of Jesus in the Gospel of Mark, open our hearts to understand what it truly means to follow you. Help us set aside distractions of this world and focus on the calling. May your Holy Spirit be with us all today, O God. Amen. Church, have you ever been at a crossroad? When we were first arrived at Las Vegas, I really had an experience of the crossroads, right? Have you experienced using the first time the global positioning system, the GPS before? Before Siri, before Alexa, the GPS. Remember that? The TomTom? Yeah, global positioning system. When I first had the opportunity to preach, at Maryland United Methodist Church, I used this illustration. The GPS reminds you when you are turning left and turning right. In the Philippines, we have also the GPS. It's not the machine, but it is when you are driving as husband, your GPS is your wife, right? When you forgot to turn right, your wife or your partner will tell you, I told you, it's not right, it's left, right? I believe it's not only in the Philippines, even in the U.S., right? Now we have Siri, now we have Alexa, and sometimes we are getting mad on Siri. Hey Siri, I want to go. Please give me the direction to Journey UMC. Okay? And there are a lot of directions. If you are coming from Maryland Avenue, I may say Maryland Parkway, there are three ways. You can use Desert Inn, Charleston, or Flamingo. So sometimes I am confused when I ask Siri for direction, and he keeps on, see, sorry, I don't understand. Siri responded to my iPad. Okay, I'm not talking to you, Siri. So where am I? So when I use the Siri, asking for directions, I always make myself out of way, lost. Siri is giving me the way, using the freeway. But living here at Las Vegas for 5 years, I don't need Siri anyway, because when I use Siri, I make myself lost. Yes, have you experienced that too? So I am memorizing all the local roads and the streets. So without Siri, I can do it by myself. And Kuya Angel told me that. You have to learn. Yeah. When I was learning, starting to drive here, Kuya Angel told me, you have to learn the side street. And now, thank you, Kuya, for reminding me that. In our lives, church, sometimes we are also lost, right? We don't know what will be the way going to the place where we wanted to go. In our faith, there are also crossroads. So how do we choose Christ over comfort in our crossroads of faith? Church, the Bible says, Jesus is teaching about taking up the cross. What taking up the cross means. The story of Peter. Peter is a prime example of what it means to reach a spiritual crossroad. Peter declares that Jesus is the Messiah. How about you? Do you also declare that Jesus is the Messiah? He gets it right. Peter is right. But when Jesus starts talking about his suffering and his death, Peter steps in and rebukes him. Can you imagine that? Telling Jesus that Jesus is wrong? Jesus is wrong about his mission. It's like telling a mathematics teacher 2 plus 2 is actually 5. No, 2 plus 2 is 4. And what Jesus responded? Get behind me, Satan. Ouch! Peter went from rock star disciple, so being called Satan. Satan means adversary. Satan means someone who is doing not good to you. So church, in our faith, how do we recognize who Jesus is? My uncle's name is Jesus. Whenever they have a fight between husband and wife, my aunt cannot shout, Jesus, you're bad, because his name is Jesus in the Philippines. And even I know here in the U.S., when someone you have a fight with, sometimes you discuss a lot of things and you are not in favor of that idea, and sometimes you have to yell or shout to him or to her, right? But this, my auntie, cannot shout on my uncle because his name is Jesus. He can say that, Jesus, I am mad on you. He can say that. It reminds my aunt that Jesus is God. Who do you say I am? Jesus asked Peter. You are the Messiah. This is the foundation of our faith, right? Jesus is our Savior. Jesus died for me, for you, for everyone. Jesus is the one and only Son, the begotten Son of God, sent to this world to die for us. So church, ask yourself, who do I say Jesus in your life? Who is Jesus for you? God, Savior. We have a hymn, Jesus, what a friend we have in Jesus. Jesus is my friend. Jesus is my rock. Jesus is my Savior. He is not only a history church, but he is God We need Jesus. We need God. We need our Savior. And we need God in our lives. But in this very complicated world, church, some people don't recognize that Jesus is God. They wanted to change history. They wanted to revise the Bible. They wanted to see and hear, read what they wanted to hear all about Jesus. During the Apostle Paul, when he wrote the letter to the Romans, he said, someday, that this was 22,000 more or years ago, Paul said, someday, people wanted to hear what they want. And it is happening right now. It is happening right now. A lot of people, they don't believe that Jesus is God. A lot of people nowadays, they don't recognize that Jesus is the Messiah. A lot of people nowadays, they don't believe that Jesus died on the cross for our salvation. They were wrong. It is written. We will never attain eternal life, church, without Jesus. We believe, yes, Jesus is history. But more than history, Jesus is God. And each and every one of us, we have to choose the way that God in Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. It is a reminder for us, church. Even Jesus predicts his suffering. Even Jesus knows, and he called his disciples in that upper room that he will suffer and die. But sometimes, people nowadays, and even ourselves, we forgot that Jesus died for us. When we choose the crossroad of faith, choosing between Christ over comfort, we want that comfort other than Jesus, right? We wanted to be in a comfort zone rather than a very challenging life volunteering in the ministry of the church. We want in a comfort zone that we used to do in our personal living and in our personal wanting. Church, how do you choose the way of your faith? Do you choose comfort or Christ? Life is not easy today, unlike before. But even life is different today. The same Jesus is Jesus. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. What does it mean for you, church, when Jesus again and again asking the question, are you really following me as your Savior and Lord? Jesus calls us every day denying oneself, ourselves, taking up the cross and follow Him. This is a daily decision. Sometimes we forgot to pray, to kneel to the Lord, and getting up before going to our workplace. Sometimes we forgot to pray before meal, thanking God that God gave the meal, our food on the table. Sometimes or more often or every time, we forgot before going to bed to thanking God for the whole day and even the 24/7 that God is taking care of us. So today, church, is a reminder. Yes, life is really complicated in this world. Life is not used to be when we were young. But remember, Jesus is always the same Jesus who died on that cross for you and for many. Without Jesus, without God creating you, we can never attain who we are now. Sometimes we are so relaxed in our comfort zone. We don't want to travel a lot, or we don't want to extend ourselves, our time in doing this and doing the ministry of God. But church, remember, again, life is really too short. The church needs you. And God, we need God. Last week, again, I received a message from the Philippines. Another member died, a young member. He is only 45 years old. You see, life is really too short. Let us serve God. Let us serve people. Let us volunteer once again, in the ministry of the church. Without God, we are nothing. Remember that. And as we reflect on the crossroads of our faith, choosing between God, between Jesus, and between comfort, life is not easy, I know. Life is not easy here in the United States. And not only in the United States, life is not easy around the world. But remember, Jesus said to us, I will never leave you nor forsake you. In choosing in the crossroad of our faith, let us be reminded that whatever we choose, whatever crosses we have now, struggles, pain, remember, Jesus is always with us. Amen. To God be the glory. If you are able, please stand and join me as we recite the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us trespasses. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil, from thine, the kingdom, the power, forever. Amen.
You may be seated. You are invited to place a donation in one of the offering plates as they are passed by our ushers. Or you can give online as shown on the screen or scan the QR code. For God loves a cheerful giver, and God is able to provide you with every blessing in abundance so that by always having enough of everything, you may share abundantly in every good work. Thank you. join me in prayer? Divine source of wisdom, we bring these offerings with hearts attuned to your call. As we gather in your presence, may our gifts reflect the wisdom and discernment you desire for us. Use these offerings to nurture understanding, compassion, and justice in our world. Guide us to listen and act with insight, spreading your love and grace. Transform our giving into actions that make a difference. Help us grow in our faith and commitment to your ways. In the holy name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Let's sing, "Make Me a Channel of Your Peace." God of mercy, God of hope, be with us, not only today, but the rest of our lives. As the worship service comes to an end, O God, we are being reminded that life is not easy. It is not easy to realize that if we are following you, we will have to make a total commitment. A commitment to your ways. Help us, Lord, to practice the goodness of compassionate love, loving our neighbors as we love ourselves, loving you. Help us, Lord, that even in a situation concerning our family, friends, neighborhood, and the world, even it is really hard, even life is complicated, help us, Lord. Help us, Lord, so we can be an instrument of thy peace. Help us, Lord, to remember that the same healing, the healing of mercy, that when the first time we have been called to follow you, be with us, with my, our families, our friends. Thank you for everything. And continue to bless us all, O God. For this is our prayer in your name. Amen. Beloved, may you accept the blessing of God, that God will take care of you, and God's peace be with you now and forever. Amen. Amen. Let us continue singing. Make me a channel of your peace. Make me a channel of your peace.